I guarantee that at least at one point in your Call of Duty career, you've been like, wow, that is so OP, that is so broken. But what about the weapons that were actually broken? The weapons that, when you took a look at them in-game, they made no sense as to why they were so good, or in some cases, that were actually broken to the point of they shouldn't be like that. Today we're going to be taking a look at 8 weapons that fit exactly that criteria, that whether or not they were patched or they never were patched, there was definitely something that you could look at it under a microscope and say, that shouldn't be like that. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. We're actually going to start out this list with one that's actually relatively recent in the grand scheme of the Call of Duty franchise. We're going to be taking a trip back to Infinite Warfare here with this one, to which we end up seeing the Proteus was a brand new sniper shotgun hybrid weapon. But if you took a look at this on day one, the first day that it was offered and available to the public, for those players that ended up getting it via either the season pass or the challenges to actually do it, or a weapon variant of some sort to unlock it without having either of those done, you had the option to play around with a sniper shotgun, and when you did so, there was actually, not kidding, an aimbot effect that happened whenever somebody was in your general vicinity and in your viewpoint. If you could see them, didn't matter how far or how close, all you had to do was pull the trigger and you got the kill. So literally taking the range of a sniper, but the damage and damage spread that a shotgun would have, and you got what you had on day one of the Proteus within Infinite Warfare. Now, of course, this was naturally changed out and you can no longer do this, but for the longest time on that day, or what seemed like the longest time, because again, still time all the same, you ended up having literally an aimbot shotgun. Didn't matter range, didn't matter how close, didn't matter where at, if you were aiming at them or not, all you had to do was pull the trigger and you got a kill. So that was definitely one of the most broken instances in Call of Duty history for sure. But moving along a little further, let's jump back to a classic one that a lot of you guys, if you've been around the community long enough, probably experienced for yourself way back in the golden age or golden era of Call of Duty. That being the original Model 1887s. This is something that Modern Warfare 2's famous shotguns were, again, the same thing as the Proteus, essentially, a range machine, not exactly as bad as the Proteus from Infinite Warfare, but pretty close. You still had the range of a decent rifle that you could end up gunning somebody down with the Model 1887s, and being that it's akimbo, while the damage might not have been the best at range, you had 2 shots essentially, all in one, where you could shoot once, both of them, reload, and get right back into the action. So it was something, if you jumped into Modern Warfare 2 in its prime, you probably experienced this, and you probably raged if you weren't the one using it at some point. This wasn't a secret or anything like that. Everybody pretty much ran around with Model 1887s at the time, and especially with akimbo, it was ridiculously good. Third up on this list comes back to literally another broken thing. This was a glitch in-game, not anything that required you to mod your controller or anything like that, but a glitch in-game for the Javelin in Modern Warfare 2. For those of you guys that remember this one, it wasn't the most practical, but man, was it great for trolling people if you ended up doing it. So essentially what it was you ended up glitching out your custom class to the point where you had essentially a dead man's hand switch. You ended up bringing out your Javelin after you cooked a Semtex, but the way that it would work is that you could end up going into an area, and if somebody killed you, it would blow up with a blast radius that was pretty big. I don't know the exact details on how far it reached, but if you were in a close quarters environment, if you went into, say, a bunker and there are 3 people with you, even though you die, you'd probably take all 3 of them out with you. And that's also one thing to bear in mind here, is that this was rampant literally just for the trolling aspect of it, because you didn't really get any beneficial reward out of it. You were going to die, but however many people you could take out with you, that's really up to the glitch itself and how close to people you were. So you had to die to end up getting this, but you could end up getting multi-kills with massive explosions as a result of this Javelin glitch. But pretty broken, right? After that, we're gonna fast forward a little bit in time to another more recent title, that being Black Ops 3, and this goes back to the beta, because as with a couple of the other weapons we'll discuss here in this list, this was a weapon that was so ridiculously good that it had to be nerfed a ton of times, and it's still solid even after all the nerfs. But that is the Razorback from Black Ops 3's beta. And if you played the Black Ops 3 beta, it was really only limited, I think, to the first weekend for PlayStation 4 users, but the Razorback was a weapon that was available via a higher unlock. It wasn't anything they got right off the bat, but if you played the beta long enough, obviously you're gonna get it, and as people being capped out, they couldn't prestige or anything like that, you'd run into a lot of people using this. But as you guys know, the Razorback is an SMG, and it's still solid even to this day, But back in the day, whenever it was first introduced to us in that beta, it had the damage of what seemingly was an LMG with the mobility of an SMG and the range of a rifle. So all that categorized into one, and you had a weapon that would absolutely shred any enemy to bits. You could go on insane kill streaks, you could end up going on absolute tears, and you'd pull off some ridiculous gameplays here with this. Couple that in with the fact that Rejack was actually broken to the point where it didn't cut off your streaks within the beta as well, and man, you had a streak spam fest within whatever map you were playing. And for those people you're playing against, well, mercy on their souls, because they were not getting out of spawn anytime soon. Fortunately for the balance of the game, the Razorback itself was actually adjusted once again, not only in that beta, but many times throughout the Black Ops 3 lifecycle. And if you were to go and take a look at Black Ops 3 and the Razorback now, it's still a solid choice, but it fits that SMG classification as it should. After that, talking about weapons that were just ridiculously OP and then got nerfed into oblivion, we're gonna jump back a little bit to Call of Duty Ghosts, because with this, if you ended up taking a look at the game on launch the first couple of days in November, the MSBS assault rifle was insane. Now, it's still pretty solid, but might be outclassed depending on where you're at and what sort of situation you're in, but at launch, pre-patch MSBS, it was a two-shot at literally any range. You didn't even have to complete a full burst. This was a three-burst weapon, but only took two shots to kill at seemingly any range. Now, as time progressed, it did have that range nerfed, and as such, it wasn't as great at those longer ranges, but it's still solid up close, and of course, even mid-range, it'll take a burst to two bursts to end up killing. But if you ended up taking a look at it while it was a brand new weapon, the game was still brand new and fresh on everybody's consoles, the MSBS was a two-shot at any range. Kind of insane when you think about it and how overpowered it might be compared to any sort of other engagement. You could just simply walk past somebody that's head glitching a ledge all the way across the map, and even if you spot them, you're dead because it only takes two shots and not even one burst to kill. Thankfully though, that's been fixed out and no longer behaves as such compared to what it was whenever it was back in the day. Next up, we're gonna talk about one that I can almost guarantee if you've played it back in the day, this is one of your favorite loadouts because it's just insane. That being the UMP-45 from Modern Warfare 2, and you can throw on a number of different things to make this even better. Stopping power is great because it's a three shot literally at any range with stopping power. Then the silencer, of course, doesn't really even reduce damage all that much, and it keeps you off the radar. So it's just ridiculously overpowered no matter what way you spin it. And of course, this is one that is as old as the game itself. It's not a secret once again, and it's been something players have used for absolute ages, but when you take a look at just the sheer power of it in any engagement, it is one of the most well-rounded weapons in Call of Duty history. Three shots at almost any range, and with that ability of a silencer not hindering it at all, you can't go wrong with the UMP-45, and there's a reason why it's loved by so many people and why it's been used for so long. Honestly, other than that, there's not really much to say. I know that's probably one of the most self-explanatory of this list, so that said, UMP-45, silenced stopping power, whatever you want to put on it, it's insane. The second to last weapon we'll talk about here in this list deals with Black Ops 3 once again, and we're talking about it in a broken perspective because of the potential it had for modding and how modded it actually got. Chances are, if you play Black Ops 3 at any point during the main life cycle, you ran into somebody with this, but the Brekky from Black Ops 3 is one that's a semi-auto shotgun, and with some of the things that were glitched, modded, whatever you want to put it as, there were things like jitter mods that ended up coming out, there were things that allowed for exploits for the fire rates, and therefore, it was just ridiculous. It doesn't at its base have the best range, but when you add in the fact that you can just spam it, it ends up adding up over time in that distance. So therefore, it becomes a very formidable weapon and something you absolutely hate going up against, and when you play maps that are smaller and have some lines of sight like a nuke town, well, it just becomes incredibly annoying to die to that over and over again. And then when you add in the fact that it can literally be broken so that you can adjust the fire rates, it just becomes something that is insanely unfair. So the Brekky is one that will probably live in infamy as that weapon nobody loved to go up against, but definitely makes the list here of broken weapons in COD history. And the final thing we'll be talking about deals with a classic that was also revisited within Modern Warfare Remastered, but goes back to COD 4 initially, the M16 with stopping power. Now this combination made it once again, as with the MSBS, a weapon that killed in less than one burst. The M16 with stopping power could kill in two shots, three shots at any range at its very worst. And so therefore, it was something that, again, players just absolutely hated going up against. And even with the bad netcode, the bad connections of the classic COD 4, it was still a melt machine. And we saw this kind of revisited again with Modern Warfare Remastered, where initially, it was the same exact thing that we had within COD 4. And with better netcode, better connections over time, you definitely noticed it as a player, because hit detection is obviously better, and therefore, being able to have less latency between game and your reaction with it. The time to kill, I remember people at launch of Modern Warfare Remastered said was too high, even though technically it was the exact same build of what we had with COD 4, just better networking. But that said, the M16 with stopping power is again another one that, like the UMP45, lives in absolute infamy because it was so ridiculously good. Now, as with other scenarios with, say, Modern Warfare 2 even, some of the fun even came from the chaos that was the sheer unbalance of weapons like that, so you ended up coming across it very much and probably were, at the time, very used to it, but still no less, pretty insane. But that said, that's where we're gonna wrap it up here at this video. Love to get your thoughts and feedback down there in the comment section down below. Is there anything that you would add onto this list? Anything you'd maybe take off? Whatever it is, of course, let me know your thoughts. I wanted to just take a little retrospective look at Call of Duty as a history with some of the most OP and broken weapon scenarios that we've seen to date out of all the years that you may have been playing the game. So if you have anything to add, feel free to let me know. If there's anything that you may dispute, feel free to let me know as well. But hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you drop a like down below. If you are also new to the channel, make sure you guys subscribe so you don't miss a single thing regarding all things Call of Duty. Black Ops 4 and Blackout are right around the corner, so if you guys are interested in any of that, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a single thing regarding all things Call of Duty related. And of course, if you guys also want to follow me over on Instagram and Twitter, those are the best places to get connected with me outside of YouTube. Those links are down there in the description for you guys to check out if you'd like to do so. But that said, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you guys later. Take care and peace.